Yo, what's going on, guys? Flames in here, and today I'll be doing some technical analysis and also a price prediction on the graph or GRT. If you would like to subscribe or like the video, it really does help with the videos. Also, if you would like to trade alongside myself, I do post every trade that I do make every day in my Discord down below. And lastly, if you would like to make up to $250 for free in Bitcoin, just join the BlockFi link in the description as well. Now just sit back and enjoy. Okay, so we're starting off here on CoinMarketCap. We are looking at GRT versus Tether on the 8R. And as you can see in the last video, if you want to go back and check, I did draw up this red box and tell you that you should be placing your buy orders from around 9.86 cents there, laddered the whole way down to these previous lows at around 8.5 cents. And as you can see, we did come back down, retest this level twice before getting a move on up, and actually we have closed above this trend line. Now, if you did manage to place your buy orders on this level, you would currently be up to current prices around 11.41%, and then to those highs you'd be up around 13%. So congratulations if you did take that trade that I did mention in our previous video. But now that we have actually got a nice bounce off that level and got the breakout of this trend line, what is next? Now, if we do drop back to lower time frames here and take a look at our trend line, we have just managed to flip this level to support there in the past couple of hours. We have come back down for the retest there. We pumped up there to around 11 cents, and now we are starting to see a small sell-off. Now, this really does depend on BTC, whether we do continue with our breakout or it is just a fake out and we do manage to fall back. I did have this level drawn up. You can go and check my Twitter if we have a quick look at it here. I did tweet this out, just BTC 4R, where BTC was sitting just below our equilibrium of this parallel channel. And then as you can see, we did actually manage to get that breakout, come up and retest that box perfectly. Now, if we do manage to sort of flip this level to support, I could easily see BTC pushing up towards the upper level of this box. We'll even drop back to the 4R just to take a look at this quickly. And if we do manage to push up towards this level, I would say that our 200 moving average would maybe be coming up towards this level. We could easily see a rejection off that, maybe come down, retest this level, hold a higher low there, or even come back down for the retest here on 19.5K. Now, if we do manage to see continuation, I would say this 21.7K mark would be a good level to maybe take your profits and flip short. And then above that, we do have this more macro trend line that I have talked about previously, and then we have 23.8K. So these are the levels that I would be taking profit, and if we do manage to see a pullback, I would be probably laddering my buy orders from around $20,400 down there to that horizontal level at 19.6K. Now, moving back on over to GRT, if we do manage to see the breakout of this, it does manage to hold, I would say a move up towards 11.8 cents would be fairly likely there. And then if we do manage to flip this level to support, I would say we could easily be pushing up to around 14.4 cents. Now, even if we take a trend line here and go from this wick, we get a good bit of price action there on this level. So we came for the retest once again, and then our last time before actually moving up towards this upper end again. So if we do measure our move here from this high to this low, if we do manage to get that breakout, the technical target would be sitting there at around 16 cents. We could easily see us push up towards that level. Let's see if we move back here. That would be pretty confident here with this level of resistance. As you can see, we came up, rejected off it here, rejected off it again. We got a slight deviation, then a pretty big sell-off. And then I would say another retest is on the cards if BTC does manage to hold. Now, if we drop back to the 4R here, say this is just a deviation. Let me draw it up. So say we do manage to get this breakout. We don't manage to hold this level as support on the retest. We come back down, get a bearish retest on this level. Then I would say we could easily be pushing down towards our POC here at around 10 cents. And if we do manage to lose this level, then we could easily come back down and test this lower level at around 9.5 cents. Now, if BTC does start to see a pullback, then this is where you could start sort of laddering your buy orders down towards 8.5 cents there. And I would say this is definitely a good level for you to place yourself some buy orders. Say we come down, get that bearish retest. We could be coming down here, hopefully holding this as support, maybe a slight deviation before coming back up, getting that retest, holding a higher low compared to back here, and then hopefully we could continue on up. Before now, I would just be watching this trend line. If we do manage to hold, this could be your first TP here, and then I would put your second TP at around here. Now, moving on over, we'll take a look at the GRT-BTC pair and see where you can actually place yourself some buy orders with your sats. So moving over here and having a look. So in that previous video, I did tell you to have your buy orders laddered from around 508 sats there down towards 440 sats. And as you can see, we did come down, get a slight deviation below that a couple of times. But once we did manage to flip that back to support, we have seen a nice move. So if you did manage to, say, place your buy orders at around this level, you would have got yourself around a 10% move there on the 25th of August. You could have sold up there, taken your profits, come back down for the retest. You could have placed a few more buy orders. We did test it another three times there before moving up another 8.5%. So some nice gains could have been made if you did watch that previous video and place those buy orders. But if you did not, you haven't actually opened any trades yet, we are at a pretty uncertain point here. If we do manage to come up and say we do manage to bounce off this 50 moving average, then flip this 200 moving average to support, we could see some more movement towards the upside, maybe even testing sort of this level here at around 592 sats. And if we manage to flip that level to support, you would like to see a move up towards to test these highs. Now, if we do manage to even come up, reject off this 200 moving average, come back down, flip the 50 moving average to resistance, we could easily see that bearish retest, come back down, test this POC, maybe reject off that. And this is where you could start to place some buy orders once again at around 505 sats there, laddered down to around 442 sats. Now, we'll quickly move on over here to CoinMarketCap and take a quick look at GRT here and see what is going on. GRT, and it is currently sitting at rank number 57. We're at 10.95 cents. We're up 6.81% there in the last 24 hours. Our market cap is 755.8 million. Our circulating supply is 6.9 billion. And that is 69% there of our max supply, which is 10.05 billion. Now, if we move down here, our all-time high is sitting at $2.88, which was 2 years ago on February 12th, 2021. And we are currently down 96.19% from then. Now, if you do want to do a little bit more fundamental research, you can have a read through CoinMarketCap's write-up here. Just pause the video. Or if you would like to do a little bit more fundamental research, you can move on up here to their website, which is thegraph.com. And over here, you'll find out everything that you need to know to sort of help you make your decision on whether you would actually like to invest in this. And if you do come over here, figure that you do actually want to pick yourself some up, then you can move back on over to CoinMarketCap, click on markets, and this will show you where you can actually do so. Now, I hope you did enjoy. If you did, please leave a like, comment, subscribe, and turn on those notifications so you don't miss